Ascidians are marine invertebrates that live attached to hard surfaces. They are also called sea squirts because when they are taken from the water, they contract and water squirts out of their body through their siphon. About 3,000 species are currently known, but many new species are described every year. Ascidians can be solitary or colonial. When solitary, they appear as small faces with two holes for water circulation. When colonial, individuals reproduce by budding, and the buds remain connected to each other, forming the colony. Research of the budding pattern is helpful in understanding regeneration processes in vertebrates, because ascidians are in the tunicata, the sister group of the vertebrata. Although adult shape is due to their sessile habit, their larvae are mobile and have all chordate features. They look like tadpoles. Larvae of a few ascidian species are studied by embryologists as model animals for understanding chordate evolution. Ascidians are classified as tunicates because they have a tunic that completely covers their body. The tunic is living tissue that contains blood vessels, cellulose fibers, and provides both mechanical and chemical protection from their environment. Ascidians produce chemicals by secondary metabolism that can be toxic, and so studies examine different species to look for molecules that may be used to fight cancer. At least one product discovered in Ascidia turbinata is already on the market. A lot about ascidian biology is very cool and fascinating. For example, their pharynx produces a mucus net that filters water being pumped through their bodies and captures very small organisms, including bacteria. So, ascidians play a very important role in the ecosystem by clearing the water that they pump through their body. Another example is that they can reverse the direction of blood flow in their bloodstream. The heart is tubular and has two pacemakers instead of one, as in people. One in each end of the tube. By taking turns every few seconds or minutes, blood flow changes direction. Some tropical colonial ascidians have symbiotic algae on their surface, in their common cloacal cavities or within the tunic. In most cases, the symbiotic algae is a cyanobacteria called prochloron. Perhaps these ascidians benefit from photosynthesis by the algae, but algae gain a reliable resource of nitrogen and protection against UV light. We find ascidians on rocks, mangrove roots, floating logs, and almost anything that stays submerged. They are also on artificial substrates such as ropes, buoys, floating docks, and hulls of boats and ships. That's why many species are being transported to different places in the world where they may become invasive, usually causing economic loss to aquaculture, especially for shellfish farming. They attach to the ropes and buoys or on the bivalve shells themselves. Some people eat ascidians, either raw, cooked, dried, or pickled. But not all species are edible, because some have toxic chemicals in their tunic. In Chile, they eat piuri, which is Piura chilensis, collected directly in the intertidal zone. In Korea and Japan, Halocynthia uretzi, the sea pineapple, is farmed. Those species are taken from the tunic to be cooked, while in Korea, people cook Staila clava still in the tunic, because they enjoy the feeling of the animal exploding in their mouth. In summary, ascidians are very interesting animals for many reasons, including their evolutionary closeness to the vertebrates, which makes them good models for research in evolution. Also, their diversity is far from understood, and they are ecologically important in benthic communities. Finally, they are economically very important in both bad and good ways. Bad when invasive, which can cause economic problems, and good when useful as cooked food or medicine.